take it. The price is too high. Feelings are gone. It seems the river's run dry. You never imagined it could turn out so rough. You're giving, giving, giving. Still, it's never enough.
Well, good morning. Welcome to Wednesday's Reflection. We're continuing to think about Samuel's phrase, multifaceted love. He spoke about it at Angie and Ty's wedding blessing this summer. Hope we gave you something to stir your thoughts yesterday.
David Attenborough, Simon Reeve, Chris Packham, Greta Thunberg, and Adi Adepitan. If you watch any programs presented by these people, then you'll realize that today we are focusing on climate change and its reversal. Let's read from Genesis chapter 1, verses 26 to 30.
Then God said, "Let us make mankind in our image, in our likeness, so that they may rule over the fish in the sea and the birds in the sky, over the livestock and all the wild animals, and over all the creatures that move along the ground."
So God created mankind in his own image. In the image of God, he created them. Male and female, he created them. God blessed them and said to them, "Be fruitful and increase in number. Fill the earth and subdue it. Rule over the fish in the sea and the birds in the sky and over every living creature that moves on the ground."
Then God said, "I give you every seed-bearing plant on the face of the whole earth, and every tree that has fruit with seed in it. They will be yours for food. And to all the beasts of the earth, and all the birds in the sky, and all the creatures that move along the ground, everything that has the breath of life in it, I give every green plant for food." And it was so. And now from chapter 2, verses 16 to 20.
The Lord God took the man and put him in the Garden of Eden to work it and take care of it. And the Lord God commanded the man, "You are free to eat from any tree in the garden, but you must not eat from the tree of the knowledge of good and evil. For when you eat from them, you will certainly die."
Then the Lord God said, "It is not good for the man to be alone. I will make a helper suitable for him."
Now the Lord God had formed out of the ground all the wild animals and all the birds in the sky. He brought them to the man to see what he would name them. And whatever the man called each living creature, that was its name. So the man gave names to all the livestock, the birds in the sky, and all the wild animals.
Wow, that was a lot. If you see any cartoons of Adam, or hear any jokes, you could tend to think that Adam was, well, a bit of a fool. But God gave Adam a huge responsibility. And because Adam is a representative of us, we still have that huge responsibility.
Early on in the first reading, we came across the word rule. Does that conjure for you a picture of a despot or something else?
We could come up with so many facts about climate change and the need for reversal. But you've probably heard most of them. We believe our responsibility as disciples has not only lies, should I say, not only in being actively responsible in our daily activities, shopping, using resources, and leaving as low a carbon footprint as we can, but also in praying.
As we see the results of climate change, in floods in Pakistan, fires in Europe, Australia, and the Americas, drought in Eastern and Southern Africa, I hope it will cause us to investigate, to protest, to lobby, and to pray effectively and fervently, availing much. The title of an earlier series.
Psalm 139 tells us we're fearfully and wonderfully made. Made in the image of God, our Creator, God. He showered us with love in all that He made. We have received that love, and we enjoy and appreciate so many things in creation.
This helps us to understand the two words storge, a love that gives comfort and security, and filio, a love that looks for a response. We need to show our love in how we look after all that God gave us and be responsible. Love often does that. It teaches us to respond with responsibility. Going to finish with prayer.
Father, we thank you for every good gift you've given us. As we celebrate harvest, please lead us into ways of being responsible so that everyone all over the world will benefit from our discipleship.
In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen.
We'll see you tomorrow, and think about neighbours.
So you say you can't take it, the price is too high. Feelings are gone, it seems the river's run dry. You never imagined it could turn out so rough. You're giving, 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 still it's never enough. That day, Jesus didn't die for you because it was fun. He hung there for love because it had to be done. And in spite of the anguish, His word was fulfilled. 'Cause love is not a feeling, it's an act of your will. Love is not a feeling, it's an